Chapter 100. State of Huo, surnamed Ji, Count, brother of King Wu, named Ji Shuchu, he was granted the state of Huo, today's Pingyang Prefecture, Shanxi Province. State of Wei, surnamed Ji, Marquis, brother of King Wu, by the same mother. He was appointed Grand Minister of National Public Safety, and was known as Uncle Kung, because he had a piece of land there. He was granted land at Wei, today's Jizhou, Hebei Province. State of Tung, surnamed Ji, Marquis, brother of King Wu, named Ji Shuxiao. He was granted land at Teng, today's Jiangqiu County, Shandong Province. State of Jin, surnamed Ji, Marquis, the youngest son of King Wu. He was called Tang Shuyu, as he was granted land at Tang, but was soon re-granted land at Jin, today's Pingyang Prefecture, Shanxi Province. State of Wu, surnamed Ji, Viscount, grandson of Tai Bo, the eldest son of Tai Wang. He was granted land at Wu, today's Suzhou, Jiangsu Province. State of Yu, surnamed Ji, Duke, grandson of Zhong Yong, son of Tai Wang. He was granted land at Yu, in Taiyang County of Hedong District. State of Guo, surnamed Ji, Duke, named Guo Zhong, son of Emperor Wang Ji, brother of King Wen. Both brothers, Guo Zhong and Guo Shu, were ministers in King Wen's court. He loved them very much, and called them the two Guos. Guo Zhong was granted land at Hongnong, in today's southeast of Shanxi Province. State of Chu, surnamed Mi, Viscount, descendant of the ancient Emperor Zhuan Shu, named Yu Xiong. He served as tutor for both King Wen and King Wu. He was granted land at Jingmen, somewhere in today's Hubei Province. State of Xu, surnamed Jiang, Baron, descendant of Emperor Yao. For his ancestors' achievements, Wen Shu was granted land at Xu, today's Xuzhou. State of Qing, surnamed Ying, Count, descendant of the ancient Emperor Zhuan Shu. For his ancestors' achievements, Bai Yi was granted land at Qing, today's Xian, Shanxi Province. State of Zhu, surnamed Ying, Viscount, descendant of the ancient Emperor Xiao Hao. For his ancestors' achievements, Xu Wu Qi was granted land at Zhu, today's Zhu County. State of Ji, surnamed Jiang, Marquis, second son of Jiang Ziya. In recognition of his father's service, he was granted land at Ji, today's Dongguanzhou County. State of Zhu, surnamed Cao, Viscount, named Cao Xie, descendant of Yan'an. He was granted land at Zhu, today's Zhou County, Shandong Province. State of Xu, surnamed Xu, Marquis, descendant of the ancient Yellow Emperor. For his ancestors' achievements, Xi Zhong was granted land at Xie, today's Yizhou, Shandong Province. State of Song, surnamed Zi, Duke, named Wei Ziqi, the eldest son of King Diyi, of the Shang Dynasty. As King Zhou was improper and not virtuous, Prince Wei Zi took the sacrificial utensils to West Qi. He was later granted land at Song, today's Suiyang County. State of Qi, surnamed Si, Count, descendant of the ancient Emperor Yu. After subduing Shang, King Wu searched for the descendants of Emperor Yu. He found Dong Logong and granted him land at Qi, today's Yongqiu County, Henan Province. State of Chen, surnamed Wei, Marquis, descendant of the ancient Emperor Shun, named Yu Fu. He served King Wu as an artisan of pottery. King Wu married his eldest daughter to Yu Fu's son, and granted him land at Chen, today's Chen County. State of Zhao, surnamed Yi Qi, Marquis, descendant of the ancient Emperor Shen Nong. For his ancestors' achievements, he was granted land at Jiao, today's Hongnong, in Shan County. State of Ji, surnamed Ji, Marquis, descendant of the ancient Emperor Yao. When the new dynasty was established, King Wu found a descendant of Emperor Yao and granted him land at Ji, today's Beijing. State of Korea, surnamed Zi, known as Ji Zi, descendant and virtuous minister of the Shang Dynasty. As he was unwilling to serve King Zhou, he moved far away to the Liaodong Peninsula. King Wu granted him land in the place now known as Korea. There were 72 states granted in all. Nangongkuo, San Yishin, Hongyao, and many others were given land and honorable titles as well. That same day, King Wu held a grand banquet to celebrate and congratulate the new dukes, marquises, and others granted land. Finally, the king's treasure houses were opened to share out gold, silver, jewels, and money among the nobles. They toasted each other and drank happily, not dispersing until late that night. The next day, after all the newly appointed nobles sent King Wu letters of thanks and farewell, they left to take up their various posts. Only Ji Dan and Xiao Xu, King Wu's two younger brothers, remained in the court to handle administrative affairs. Gaojing is located in the center of the country and is therefore the most suitable place for the capital. King Wu said to Ji Dan. The king then ordered Xiao Xu to arrange the transfer of the capital from West Ji to Gaojing. Gaojing was located to the north of Xi'an in Shaanxi province, today's Xiangyang County. Prime Minister. King Wu said to Jiang Ziya one day. You are old now and may find it inconvenient to continue your service in the court. It would do you good to relax in your own state. King Wu gave Jiang Ziya precious jewels, a yellow axe, and the white scepter, representing leadership over all the dukes. Jiang was also authorized to attack any state in a punitive expedition if necessary. The next day, Jiang appeared at court to thank King Wu before leaving the capital. King Wu and his ministers then escorted Jiang as far as the southern suburb. Jiang kowtowed to thank the king and said, As you have so kindly granted me the state of Ji, I shall be unable to serve you and be in poor side day and night. I hate to leave you, for I don't know when we'll have the chance to meet again. King Wu comforted Jiang, saying, Prime Minister, you are old and have already served the royal court for so many years. I think you should return to your own state to rest and enjoy the blessings of peace and good health. I don't expect you to work hard here any longer. Jiang Ziya thanked him again and again. How can I ever return your magnificent grace? You are always so kind to me. He said. Thus, King Wu and Jiang Ziya separated that day. King Wu and his ministers returned to the capital, while Jiang Ziya went on his way to the state of Qi in Shandong. When he had settled in, Jiang Ziya thought, Many years ago when I left Mount Kunlun for Jiaoga, I was treated kindly by my sworn brother, Song Yiren. I was so busy handling state affairs, I never had the chance to express my thanks. Now that everything is settled, it would be most ungrateful if I didn't send him a letter with my best regards and a small gift. Jiang Ziya sent a special messenger to Jiaoga with a letter and 1,000 katas of gold to pay his respects to Song Yiren and his wife. A few days later, the messenger found that unfortunately, both Song and his wife had passed away. Song's son, however, had taken over as head of the family property and was managing their business enterprises so well that he was more prosperous than ever. He received the letter and gift and sent the messenger back to express his thanks. Jiang Ziya governed his state according to the law and directed the people to work properly. After 5 months, everything was in good order, and everyone was living peacefully and happily. After Jiang Ziya passed away, his son Zhao succeeded him as ruler of the state. Xiao Bai, his later descendant, appointed Guanzhong as prime minister, and Xi ruled superior over all the states during the spring and autumn period of the Zhou dynasty. In the days of Kang Gong, the Qi state was taken over by the Tian family. At Gaojing, King Wu ruled the country well, enabling all within the four seas to enjoy peace. The people lived happily and everyone prospered. King Wu was a virtuous ruler, just like the ancient emperors Yao and Shun. After King Wu's death, King Cheng succeeded to the throne, with the assistance of his uncle, Ji Dan. The country continued to enjoy peace and prosperity. The Zhou dynasty lasted a full 800 years from the days when Jiang Ziya launched his attacks against King Zhou and Ji Dan succeeded him as prime minister.